Next big story, late developments in the murder-for-hire trial of Karla Porter.
Yeah, happening right now, a Baltimore County jury has just received the case after a week of dramatic testimony, including from the defendant herself. 11 News I-Team reporter Barry Sims has been following this trial since the very beginning. He joins us live from outside the courthouse in Towson with the very latest. Barry?
Stan, the jury does have the case right now, and Karla Porter's attorneys have argued for a conviction of voluntary manslaughter. They don't deny that she was involved in the murder-for-hire plot, but they believe that that is the conviction that the jurors should give. Of course, the prosecution believes that she should be convicted of first-degree murder.
During closing arguments, prosecutors told jurors 51-year-old Karla Porter contracted and planned the murder of her husband, that she put the plan in motion, but there was criminal teamwork. 49-year-old William Ray Porter was shot in the head multiple times March 1, 2010, as he worked at the Towson Hess gas station he owned. Baltimore County Assistant State's Attorney Jennifer Schiffer described Karla Porter's actions, saying she hired Walter Bishop Jr. to kill her husband, and she also involved her sister, brother, and nephew. Schiffer said Karla Porter's action was every bit as deadly, every bit as lethal as Walter Bishop pulling the trigger. Prosecutors argued on what they called Karla Porter's progression of lies that they said began with the 911 call and police interviews as she tried to mislead them on the description of the gunman.
Okay, a black, you said a black male came into the side door.
Schiffer said this woman cannot and should not be believed. The defense argued self-defense, claiming Karla Porter fit the profile under Maryland law of battered spouse syndrome, that she suffered from severe depressive disorder and post-traumatic stress disorder because of years of verbal and physical abuse by her husband.
I was just so tired.
Defense attorney Bill Popora argued that jurors should consider the charge of voluntary manslaughter rather than first-degree murder. He said there is no question Karla Porter lied. He said the issue is what led Karla Porter up to that day when Ray Porter was killed. Porter said, this is the action of a woman suffering recurrent physical and psychological abuse. This is the action of a woman at the end of a rope. This is the action of a woman never allowed to exhale.
Now the jury must decide between first-degree murder, second-degree murder, and voluntary manslaughter. Karla Porter is also charged with conspiracy, solicitation to commit murder, and a weapons violation. Reporting live from Towson, Barry Sims, WBAL-TV 11 News.
All right, Barry, thank you.